Welcome to CUES Tips. I'm Nick Gaines, CUES Training Coordinator, and I will be demonstrating today how to initialize the K2 system. The system is for our K2 summits, which we have in the truck today. It will also be the same steps for our K2 portable and our Mark III system. To initialize our K2 system, our first step is to power on the K2 Summit CCU. Once we get our green light to come on, we should start seeing loading CUES firmware on our screen. This will be synonymous across all three systems. All right, now that our CUES equipment configuration screen is loaded, we'll go through the different options that you can select depending on what you have on the end of your mainline cable. Our first option here is configuration correct. It's defaulted to no, and we're not going to change that until we go through the rest of our options and make sure that they are correct. To do that, we're going to use the tab key on our keyboard, and we're going to tab through all of our options and change them as needed. The first three options here come standard out of CUES factory and should match what you have on your truck. These can be changed, but only at the assistance of a CUES person. Fourth option here is the cable length. This option is selected right now is 1500 feet. That's what we have on the end of our cable. That's what we have on our reel. This can be changed if you need to. If you've cut off some cable to do to a retermination, you can come in here and select that and change it to what the new cable length is. The next option is our transporter. All of CUES transporters are inside of here, and you can scroll through any one of them depending on what you have. Now that we have our transporter selected, we're going to tab down to our front viewing camera, and we're going to select our front viewing camera. The front viewing camera is dependent on what type of transporter you have selected. It will only give you options that work with your transporter. The next option is our rear viewing camera. If we have a rear viewing camera, we're going to change this from no to yes. If you do not have one, you can keep it on no. Our next option is an electric lift. If you have an electric lift, you can change that from no to yes. And if you don't, you can keep it on the default of no. The following option is our lights. This again will only This will be determined based on of what type of front viewing camera you have. You have a few different options in here. So you select what you have and tab to the next one. Next option is titling source. Titling source is currently set to software. That's because we are using CUES software. If you do not use software, you do not use CUES software. You're going to want to select the Summit K2 K3 as your titling source. Audio source is our next option. Currently is selected to microphone, but there is also an option of auxiliary in there. The speaker volume defaulted out of the factory is 35. That tends to be about the best for our speaker volume. This last option is for our K2 portable systems only. This is to be able to turn on and off the external speaker that is built into the K2 portable system. For now, we'll just keep that on. Once I've gone through and selected all of my options, I tab back up to the top where it says configuration correct. I change that from no to yes using my up and down arrows. Or I can select Y on the keyboard. Once I've changed that, I hit enter. And my camera will initialize. As you can see, now we have our live video. We have our copyright screen, which indicates that we have control over our camera. And we can start inspecting sewer lines. I'm Nick Gaines for CUES Tips. For further information about how to initialize the K2 system, please contact us at CUES Tips at CUESinc.com. Thank you.